We will hope later to be able to bring you direct reports from both Honolulu and Manila.
To recapitulate, the White House reported today Japanese air attacks on the Hawaiian Islands and Manila in the Philippines. Here in the studio with me is Major George Fielding Elliott, Columbia's military expert, who will analyze now these latest developments in the Far East. Major Elliott.
The Japanese appear to be taking the offensive in an effort to delay and impede American operations in the Far East. Apparently confronted with a situation in which there was no escape except war, the Japanese have attacked the main American naval base in the Pacific at Pearl Harbor on the island of Oahu in the Hawaiian Islands. This attack is by air and can only come from aircraft carriers, since the Japanese do not have any bases close enough to the Hawaiian Islands from which to launch land-based aircraft. This is a very great risk for the Japanese to place aircraft carriers within reach of the very powerful naval patrol bombers and the long-range army bombers on the island of Oahu. It is a risk which would only be assumed as a very desperate measure, one which may well result in the loss of the carriers that are making the attack, but may also gain for the Japanese important time to carry out operations in the Far East because of the damage that they may inflict on the naval base and shipping in Oahu, and thus delay the proceeding of the United States Pacific Fleet to the Western Pacific. That is probably the Japanese object, and we don't know yet what success they've had in carrying it out. They're expecting to take heavy losses, and these losses may be expected. The question is how much delay they have purchased for the carriers that they have risked.
We have been on the telephone with our station in KGMB, which is in Honolulu, and they report to us that the attacking planes number between 50 and 100, that the air raid is still on, and that the anti-aircraft fire can be heard in a steady drone as the attacking planes come in. We received a bulletin just a little while ago which reported that there have been some of these, what Manila Corps, rather Honolulu, calls unidentified planes shot down. And this latest report now from KGMB is all that we have to the moment. We will continue to receive reports from there, also from Washington, on the developments in our relations with Japan, the relations which will tell very shortly the story of what is to happen in the months that are to come. And Columbia will bring you important news bulletins during the broadcast of the New York Philharmonic Society, which follows this program, and will also bring you a summary of all developments at the intermission time. From Washington, the recruiting office of the United States Navy announces that all recruiting centers will be open at 8 a.m. tomorrow. You've been listening to Elmer Davis, Albert Warner, Bob Trout from London, and Major George Fielding Elliott with a review and analysis of the Far Eastern situation. The Wrigley Company has told us that we may interrupt their program at any time to bring you the latest bulletins. But now, we return you to our regularly scheduled program.